I want to get to some other particular things that we're dealing with at this particular time. We want to go back, because right now, my main thing right now is to deprogram the mind, to take a person to act back beyond Kemet, or back beyond what you would call Africa or ancient Africa. We want to go all the way back. So what I want to do at this particular time is actually go back. I made a pledge that if nobody didn't learn anything, they should have at least gotten these particular scriptures. So I say these on every last one of my at every last one of my particular lectures, I always give out these particular scriptures. And you notice that Psalms 82 verse 1, the people who have pencils, Psalms 82 verse 1, and God standeth on the congregation of the mighty, and he judges among the gods, which means that's judging among you because you are gods. And you must understand these particular things that's actually going on. Now, because some of this particular, these particular spirituality will work for you if you realize that you're not just a person of under God, but you are joint heirs with the Christ, and you are the Christ, and you are God too. And therefore, your whole reality will be different. Right now, I'll tell you how powerful this is, to let you know. I went to the mounds in Tennessee, an Indian mounds in Tennessee, Monday. And while we was on there, we received information that they have a whole consortium of white people that have consolidated together. And they took three black people to get the energy, all to try to put some doggone stuff on me to try to hurt me based on some witchcraft. But the stuff hadn't been working, and the particular magic is weak. Now, why is the magic weak, and why the magic cannot penetrate? Number one, first of all, the only magic that is on the planet is the magic that the black man and the black woman brought forth, or the spiritual divination systems. Because it's only power. You can use it for negative or positive. So therefore, when they unleash the particular entities on me, it's the same damn entity that I'm pouring doggone libation to. So all that coming and doing is making me more stronger. I get juice all of a sudden, and all the next thing, I got a burst of energy because some doggone crackers was doing some rituals to hurt me. But then again, there's no such thing as rituals outside of black people. You understand? And plus also, because my mind understands that what you call black magic only means black people's magic. So hell, if you giving me black people magic, it's the same damn magic that I'm invoking for my own self. So therefore, no kind of negative stuff can actually hurt me. You see, so in actuality, they've been trying for over a year, and they have tried everything, and it can't work. Another thing is humility. I don't give a doggone about nothing physical at all. I live without money, basically. You understand what I'm saying? I have no other job, and when I go do election, it might be 2 weeks apart before I go do election, and I'm the lowest paid. I say, well, I come for $300. Somebody say, I got $250. I come for that. But that's all the money I got in the world. I have no bank account. So therefore, I don't live, and my desires, how these rituals working on is they feed on your passions. So if you have a passion for money, that's what they do. They put you into the money realm, and therefore you go on that realm trying to get paid, and therefore get you off the spiritual path. You see what I'm saying? So it feeds on your passions and stuff. If you got a large ego, then the first thing happens is you start doing things, and the next thing you know, you start going against the actual people that you so-called helping, because your ego won't let you go forward. Therefore, you want somebody to worship you or bow down to you. So therefore, the whole thing is to forget this world. I don't even live in this world no more. I'm here, but I'm someplace else. You see what I'm saying? So also, I was saying, Brother Noah got a little son, and I noticed him. I noticed him the last time, and then my spirit just picked up. This little boy don't do nothing according to the laws or whatever. You say it's white, he gonna say it's black. But then again, on the other hand, I'm understanding that spiritually, he's in tune. Because also, if you are a model of this society in a world like this, and you doggone function in this society at the utmost of the standard of the society, you've got to be ultimately dead. You understand what I'm saying? Ultimately dead. Like I said, be in this world, but not of this world. Check? All right then. So now, based on this here, you must understand the year of God. If you don't get nothing, you must understand this. And that's why Psalms and John chapter 10, verse 34 to 36 says, and Jesus answered unto them, is it not written in your law that I say, ye are God? And he called them God unto whom the word of God came. And the scriptures cannot be broken. And he says, whom the Father has sanctified and sent into the world, thou blasphemest, because I have said that I am the Son of God. But that's like the disciples saying, we can't get along without you. when you're going. He said, didn't I say in my law that you are God? And just as I have done great works, greater works you should do. And be ye perfect as I am. That means in order to be perfect, you got to be the exact duplication or personification of what he is, which means that you have the same things in your body. Now, when I got a lot of good pictures here today, and when we start going into this stuff, and I'm going to show you how some things is already getting ready to go down, so you all just stick with it. Check. Now, the other one is Romans chapter 8, 14, verse 14, 16, and 17. For as many is led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God. And if our spirit bears witness, and if their spirit bears witness with our spirit, we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs. And if heirs, then joint heirs with the Christ. Which means that Christ ain't got nothing on you. He is your brother and passed through the Stargate. And he's giving you the example of what you must do because you all got the Stargate. The mystery to Christ is not one person. The mystery to Christ is you are all Christ. You understand what I'm saying? You just got to be turned on. You understand what I'm saying? Somebody got to flip that doggone remote control down at the cable office and turn your doggone light on. As simple as that. Okay? Now, I had to get that back out of the verse because I wanted to do some things on this particular part. This is some stuff coming out of England. What is a God but man? Now, they're getting this off of the Gnostic scriptures. What is a God but man? Wielding the birds of chaos. Remember that word chaos, because it's very important that you understand chaos, or what they call quantum physics, or what they call new physics in the field of education. You see, the white boys got a jump on you. They give you that garbage, mathematics, and all that bulljive. That is what you call academics, or what you call chemistry, and what you call the seven little arts, and then there's what is called occult chemistry. Occult chemistry. Occult science. Which means only that which is hidden. And they have taken the actual blueprint of where the other stuff is coming out, and they give you the actual stuff when you go into actual college to learn that stuff. And you learn the mathematics proportion is only an indicator of what there's something greater. And the spiritual stuff you don't get. That's taught in the lodge. You understand what I'm saying? That's called quantum physics, chaos physics. You understand? Which is nothing talking about melanin magic, or what you call dark matter magic. Okay, what is man but God? Wheel from the force of chaos, the black dot. And to him, nothing is true, and everything is permitted. Now, that's not talking about the white man, because the laws that came down for him is he had to have a strict code of ethics and moral dogma because he didn't know how to behave. This is talking about the God. You understand what I'm saying? So now, this is anything directly opposed to what you call fundamentalism, where somebody else is the God and you worship it. We're not saying there's not a prime creator. We're just saying that you're part of that prime creator. Hell, if you got a lake and you got a doggone beach, it is not the water in the beach and the water in the lake the same damn water. Right? All right, that's all it is. You're the microcosm of the macrocosm. It says, nothing is truth and everything is permitted. What do they mean by that? They mean that there's knowledge on top of knowledge, and when you go to this level, there's another level, and you never get on top of it. You see what I'm saying? That's why you got to neutralize the ego, because we all in the kindergarten of the knowledge, but yet we want to teach somebody something, or we want a dog going to say, this is it. And we all in kindergarten with the knowledge. You see what I'm saying? And it keeps going on. So nothing is true. Everything is permitted. There is no purpose in the existence. He is the force that chooses his own. He's talking about the God. Now, this is you. This is breaking the restrictions of what you would call moral dogma or fundamentalism from you, because it's kept you into slavery up to now. Check. He has bound himself to the earth forever and reincarnates at will until he has had enough of the teaching. You have bound yourself in this classroom until you have had enough of the teaching. You say, I'm ready to go to another level. I've been taught on this level. So even though you might be ignorant now, 360 degrees of knowledge is in you, and you have been going through reincarnation cycle, so you know the knowledge. It's getting ready to come out. Check? All right. For the universe is a mad, and it is arbitrary in her ways, which means it's chaos. Never stops moving. Y'all stick with me, because there's going to be some real deep stuff tonight when I start showing you these pictures. All right, we just setting you up. Nothing is, it says, nothing is unchangeable except change itself. You understand what I'm saying? Everything can change except change itself, because change is changing. Check? The only universal principle is the universal lack of principle. See, the only universal principle is the universal lack of principle. See, this is breaking down all of the particular stuff. I'm going to explain this in a few minutes. What I'm talking about in a few minutes. I'm going to go and explain this in a few minutes. Yet, the great black mother goddess Chaos will lend her power to those who can become her favorites. Her favorites, her original black children, with her Stargate in them. That means all this up there, the only people that's going to lend it to is the one that's got a part of that in it. Now, what do I mean by, what do I mean by the only universal principle is the lack of principle? Because I went to Hampton University. So all the little black brothers and sisters, I've met a lot of people, 18, 19, 20, you know, up to about 23, and they got only, you know, all of them got the little twists into the dreads and everything like that and all. So when you first get in Afrocentricity, the first thing you do is you learn a certain behavior. You see what I'm saying? You learn it, and I understand that first the goal and the objective is you don't want to be like the white man. So the first thing is, the brother say, brother, why you cut your hair? I say, you right. I say, first of all, I got the chemical out of it. So therefore, I don't have the stuff on the inside, so it don't shut down my crown chakra. I say, but on the other hand, he was like, well, brother, you know, why you cursing or why you doing this type thing? I say, what you doing, brother, you dealing with the physical mannerism and it's keeping you from going inside. Oh, so you learn how to, you know, you put on all the African clothes, you get the dress, all that's positive. Now, don't get me wrong. You get the dress, and then all of a sudden, you put on this particular stuff, and you learn how to be this whole Afrocentric mode, which is positive for the simple fact that you want to have a people that don't identify with white so often. But all of a sudden, you start getting stuck there. You start getting stuck there, and it keeps you from going inside. And then the next thing, the objective that you sought to change yourself becomes just as bad as the objective that you tried to drain yourself out of. You just coming from one dichotomy to the other, and you stuck in the same phase. And I said, that is because you have been trained on a moral dogma standard that you gotta act a certain way outwardly, and it shields your pathology inwardly. You understand what I'm coming from? You see what I'm saying? It seals your pathology inwardly. Check. So this is why all of a sudden, after 10 years of the Afrocentric movement, half the niggas done sold you out. Brother, and it done got over on you. You see what I'm saying? Because you don't understand until you go inwardly, it don't manifest outwardly, but you can change outwardly and it can stop the flow of going inwardly. Now, go with a few other things, because I'm going to, let's see if I can get this other piece, because I'm going to show you something on the ego. We need to deal with this particular thing. First of all, let me go into this elder race. The elder race. It says, after, now we're going to go far beyond. Now, for those people who don't believe in Atlantis and Lemuria, that's because they ain't been studied. Oh, I got with all the scholars and I said, where the hell you get this stuff from? I said, okay, you know. You want documentation. So I start documenting all the scholars at the Melanin Conference, and they had to bear witness to it. I say, you just didn't read the Hermes Flight Magistus material. Where it simply says, Tahuti comes from a land of the deluge, beyond the Nile. You see what I'm saying? And they say that his particular work is undateable. So when you talk about Atlantis and Lemuria and all that type of stuff, you talk about particular stuff, it's all in the documents. You just got to sift it out. One good book you need to get, if health research has just put it back out, is Atlantis and Lemuria by Rudolf Steiner. Atlantis and Lemuria by Rudolf Steiner. Now, this book came out in 1925, supposedly before Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Master Farah Muhammad came to teach Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And you laughed at that stuff, but yet the cracker in almost 5 years before Master Farah Muhammad came to teach him, he bearing witness to the same thing that the white man was created. The white man was created. Bearing witness that the sun was separated from the moon, all in this particular book. You see? So therefore, is it you just haven't dug deep enough? Or is there a conspiracy of hidden history and they're only giving the scholars what they want them to know? Don't go beyond Egypt for 3,000 years. And everything else is vague. You can hint on it, but you don't get the complete gnosis. Now, let's go into this particular thing. After the earth and the planet has cooled, it was ready for the inhabitants. A race arrived from outer space who was not human. Now, but was the original true race of men. Now, this particular person he's talking rubbish. He said he ain't human, but he said he had an original true race of men. You understand what I'm saying? Now, but they were called the Cyclopean race and are known in the secret arcane as the El of the Elder race. So he's doing the metaphysical thing again. He's talking to one people, and you thinking it's a damn person with a damn one eye and a forehead and no other eyes. Cyclopean means the third eye.